So majorly today we'll discuss about CRM applications. So today mainly we are discussing about two major CRM applications. One is Salesforce.com and another one is Microsoft Dynamics CRM. So first of all, we need to understand what is CRM and why it is required and for who and all it is very much useful. CRM is nothing but customer relationship management. So it's an software customer relationship management system. It is very much essential for the companies to run their advertisements, to do marketing, and to maintain the details about the customers and to be in touch with them. So therefore, this plays a very crucial thing for the companies in case of doing their marketing, advertisement, and maintaining the clients' details, and especially for the small companies as well as the startups. Salesforce.com is one such application which provides CRM solutions by using cloud computing. Salesforce.com is probably the most popular and developed CRM solutions available today. So as of today, more than 100,000, that is nothing but 1 lakh customers are using Salesforce.com CRM. The application provides customizable CRM solutions that can be integrated with additional features developed by third parties. Salesforce.com is based on Force.com cloud development platform. So that means to say that, so if you are using CRM, that is Salesforce.com CRM, you can customize it as per your requirements. And also you can use some of the third party services and that can be integrated with Salesforce.com. And Salesforce.com is basically implemented on the cloud platform called as Force.com, but still people popularly they call it as Salesforce.com cloud platform. This represents the scalable and high performance middleware executing all the operations of all Salesforce.com applications. So that means we need to understand that. So Salesforce.com provides the middleware for the cloud platform to run all its operations, all the operations of Salesforce.com CRM. So now here we need to understand Salesforce.com is a CRM solution and it is implemented on Force.com cloud platform. Let us look at the architecture of this Salesforce.com CRM solution. See in the right side. So this is the cloud system. So the cloud system, the Force.com platform mainly contains shared databases. So within the shared databases, we have data tables, pivot tables. So pivot tables are very much essential in extracting the reports based upon a specific parameters and metadata. So metadata is implemented as services. So this is UDD is a registry, that is a registry. And here you have a virtual application components. This virtual application components consists of application, common application screens, so tenant specific screens and objects. See, common application screens means you need to understand that is the dashboard related screens which are common to all the clients, and tenant specific screens, as I told, Salesforce.com can be customized for with respect to our requirements. So in that case they will be having specific screens, so that is nothing but the tenant specific screens and the object tables. Object tables are related to the data. And beyond that, we have a metadata cache memory to serve the pages, recently used pages quickly. And we have a bulk processing engine. So that means the queries will be processed in bulk, and multi-tenant aware query optimizer. The multi-tenant query optimizer, say for example, multi-tenant means say one server replying for multiple customers at a time and they are capable of executing multiple queries of multiple customers in parallel. That is called as multi-tenant query optimizer, and the runtime application generator and full text search engine. And at the same time, it also provides the provision for searching facility within the CRM solution. So because once you have a CRM solution, you can search for a particular client, or you can search for a particular company, or you can search based upon so many parameters. And in the left side, you can see a lot of user bases are there, and all these user bases are connected to salesforce.com via internet. So that means, since cloud is an network which is implemented, that which is implemented on internet, so here the user base, that is people are connecting to the salesforce.com via internet, and it supports ubiquity. So ubiquity in the sense, you can access from anywhere, anytime, just by using the internet facility. Okay, now let us move on to Microsoft Dynamics CRM. See, actually traditionally how the CRM was implemented, see, traditionally people used to install CRM as a standalone application, and they used to hire one software vendor, they used to give the requirements, and as per that they used to develop and give it to the customer, and the customer used to install it as a standalone application. Now if we take an example of Microsoft Dynamics CRM, it is available in two ways. It is available as a standalone application wherein you can install and you can start working with it, and it is also available through cloud platform. So you can have a subscription, cloud subscription, or you can purchase the complete license and you can install it, Microsoft Dynamics CRM. It is a solution implemented by Microsoft for customer relationship management. Dynamics CRM is available either for installation on the enterprise's premises or as an online solution priced with monthly per user subscription. So that means, as I told, you can install it on premise or you can buy it for monthly subscription, per user subscription. The system is completely hosted in Microsoft's data centers across the world and offers to customers 99.9% service level agreement with bonus credits in case the system does not fulfill the agreement. See, since you are using it online mode, that is by using cloud computing, so they will assure you 99.9% service level agreement. So they say that, so all the time our application will be up and running and we can cater to your needs. In case if they violate, they'll give you bonus credits, so that will be financially that will give financial benefit to the customers. Each CRM instance is deployed on a separate database, and the application provides users with facilities for marketing, sales, and advanced customer relationship management. So that means, what are the things you can do with it is marketing, sales, and advanced customer relationship management. So sales means, you know, marketing, also, you know, campaigning. And what is this advanced customer relationship management? So sometimes you want leads to attract more customers. So using that, you can get the leads also. So that becomes one of the advanced feature. And Dynamics CRM online features can be accessed either through a web browser interface or programmatically by means of SOAP and RESTful web services. So that means in two ways you can access Dynamics CRM. One is simply by using the browser, using the dashboard, you can access the Dynamics CRM. And if you want to access it programmatically by using SOAP and RESTful web services, you can access it. This allows Dynamics CRM to be easily integrated with both other Microsoft products and line of business applications. So therefore, this can be also integrated with other Microsoft products. Whatever the other Microsoft, like SkyDrive and so many other applications are there, Office 365 and so on, you can integrate with that. And Dynamics CRM can be extended by developing plugins that allow implementing specific behaviors triggered on the occurrence of given events. Dynamics CRM can also leverage the capability of Windows Azure for the development and integration of new features. So even further, if you want to add new features, so by using the Microsoft Windows Azure PaaS platform, you can even develop the new features and you can add it. And at the same time, you can also develop new specific plugins for your requirement and you can use it as per your requirements. Okay, so the takeaway from this Microsoft Dynamics CRM is, so it is available in two versions. That is, you can purchase the full license and you can install it on premise, or you can go for the online model where they'll be charging per user per month. Okay, and they will assure you 99.9% of service level agreement. So now if you look at, if you compare and contrast both Salesforce.com and Microsoft Dynamics CRM, the major difference is that Salesforce.com is available only on online subscription, whereas Microsoft Dynamics is available in two variants, both as an standalone application as well as online subscription. Okay, that's it from CRM applications. Okay, now let us see one more application with respect to storage application. So how cloud computing is used for online to provide online storage facility. Let us take an example of Dropbox. Okay, let us see how this Dropbox is implemented. One of the core features of cloud computing is to be available anywhere at any time and from any internet connected device, which is nothing but ubiquity. Therefore, document storage constitutes a natural application for such technology. Online storage solutions are precedent to cloud computing, but they have never become popular. With the development of cloud technologies, they have turned into software as a service applications and become more usable as well as more advanced and accessible. So that means, so with the advent of cloud computing, so providing online document saving facilities, so has become a common thing, but still it is not so popular. So why? Because you see, you have SkyDrive, you have Google Drive, you have Dropbox, and so many iCloud. So because of huge competition, apart from Google Drive, no other application has become so much popular. Perhaps the most popular solution for online document storage is Dropbox. This is an online application that allows you to synchronize any file across any platform and any device in a seamless manner, which is exactly similar to the Google Drive. Dropbox provides users with a free amount of storage that is accessible through the abstraction of a folder. So that means, just like how you use a Google Drive, you can save your files and also the folders using Dropbox, and to up to certain limit it is free. Say for example, up to 10 GB, 15 GB it will be free. So if you cross that limit, they will charge for your document storage. Users can either access their Dropbox folder through a browser or by downloading and installing a Dropbox client. Just like how you install the Google Drive desktop version, that is called as a client version, which provides access to the online storage by means of a special folder. All the modifications into this folder are silently synced so that changes are notified to all local instances of the Dropbox folder across all devices. So that means, once you are storing some document in your locally downloaded Dropbox client, that will get synchronized with all the Dropbox instances that you have installed when you are connecting to the internet. The key advantage of Dropbox is its availability on different platforms like Windows, Macintosh, Linux, and even on mobile platforms, and the capability to work seamlessly and transparently across all of them. So that means Dropbox is a facility which is provided as software as a service to store your documents online, and it supports ubiquity so that by using a mobile, laptop, palm top, desktop, any of the internet enabled device, you can access it. And at the same time, if you want to store it locally, you can download the client version, which is called as a, say for example, popularly we call it as a desktop version. You can download it and you can access it. Another interesting application in this area is iCloud, which is similar to Dropbox. iCloud is a cloud-based document sharing application provided by Apple to synchronize iOS-based devices in a completely transparent manner. So therefore, now we need to understand the context of iCloud. iCloud is a product of Apple. So therefore, it is applicable only within the context of Apple-based devices. Differently from Dropbox, which provides synchronization through the abstraction of local folder, iCloud has been designed to be completely transparent once it has been set up. Documents, photos, and videos are automatically synced as changes are made without any explicit operation. So that means, so once you are storing some documents within that iCloud, and if you do any updations, so without any user intervention, automatically it will get synchronized, just like the Google Drive. This allows to efficiently automate common operations without any human intervention. Taking a picture with an iPhone and having it automatically available in iPhoto on your Mac at home, editing a document in the iMac at home, and having the changes updated in the iPad. So all these things will be automatically synchronized and updated. Unfortunately, this capability is limited only to iOS devices, and currently there are no plans to provide iCloud with a web-based interface that would make users' content accessible even from unsupported platforms. So that means it is not as elegant as Dropbox or Google Drive. So it is available only on iOS devices. So wherever iOS OS is installed, only on those devices it is available, and they don't have any plans to make it available using web. So that means they don't provide web-based interface. So look at the Dropbox scenario here. So this is one example of how people are using Dropbox. See, in Dropbox, they have stored Excel, Word, MS Word files, Excel files, images, and PDF files. Okay, actually, so this is a cloud representing the Dropbox cloud platform. So documents are stored. And here people are accessing by using the mobile phone. So they are downloading and accessing. So they are uploading and downloading PDF files, Word files, images, and so on. So same thing here, even by using the desktop also, people are accessing the Dropbox. So that means, so by using any web-enabled device, you can access Dropbox. Next is Google Docs. Google Docs is also a software as a service, which is provided by Google App Engine, or we can say Google Cloud. It's an application that delivers the basic office automation capabilities with support for collaborative editing over the web. The application is executed on top of Google distributed computing infrastructure that allows the system to dynamically scale according to the number of users using the service. So that means the Google Docs is dynamically scalable. So there is no restriction. So say, for example, all the employees in your organization can use it at a time. So there are no limitations. Google Docs allows creating and editing text documents, spreadsheets, presentations, forms, and drawings. So that means that is not only limited to Office. So it is further extended to forms and drawings. You can edit and update the forms and drawings as well. It aims to substitute desktop products such as Microsoft Office and Open Office and provide similar interface and functionality as a cloud service. It supports collaborative editing over the web for most of the applications included in the suite. So that means they want to provide alternative solutions for MS Office and Open Office. So Open Office is available in Linux-based systems, and Microsoft Office is available in Windows-based machines. And you know that, so it is not freely available, Microsoft MS Office. So it is paid service. So instead of that, say for example, so when you don't want to purchase a Microsoft Office, but still you want to use, so yeah, and nowadays we know that internet is very cheap, so you can use Microsoft Office online, that is by using Google Docs. So whatever the functionality Microsoft Office provides, all those functionalities are provided by Google Docs as well. This eliminates tedious mailing and synchronization tasks when documents needed to be edited by multiple users. That means multiple users at a time in parallel can edit the documents. by being stored in the Google infrastructure, these documents are always available from anywhere and any device this is connected to the and that is connected to the internet. Moreover, the suite allows users to work offline in case the internet connectivity is not available. That means when internet connectivity is not available, we can work offline, then you can sync it when you are connecting to the internet. The support of various formats such as those that are produced by the most popular desktop office solutions allows user to easily import and move documents in and out of Google Docs, thus eliminating barriers for the use of this application. So that means it supports various formats. Say for example, if I consider Word document, so it supports .doc and .docx. Similarly, Excel, .xls and .xlx. So, and if I take images, .bmp, .png, so .jpg, and so on. So it supports multiple formats. Google Docs is a good example of what cloud computing can deliver to end users. Ubiquitous access to resources, elasticity, absence of installation and maintenance costs, and delivery of core functionalities as a service. So that means when you are using Google Docs, you need not worry about how to install, and you need not pay any money. Just if you have internet, that is good enough. And it is ubiquitous. You can access from any device, from anywhere, provided you have internet capacity, and it supports elasticity. Okay, that's all about Google Docs. Okay, so by this, we have finished our cloud computing syllabus. Okay, now we have finished cloud computing syllabus 100%. Now from past three classes, just we are exploring various use cases of cloud computing. Similarly, so in this, today I'll send this PPT. Even if there are a few more applications like iOS architecture, Facebook, and Animoto. So just you can refer. So what are the applications of cloud computing? Okay, that's all for today's class. So, okay, just let us see the summary. So in this chapter, we presented a brief overview of applications developed for the cloud or that leverage cloud technologies in some form. Different application domains can take advantage from cloud computing, from scientific applications to business and consumer applications. So that means, so let it be any domain, there are applications of cloud. So let it be scientific application or business application or consumer application. So there are always applications of cloud computing. And even if you take geo satellite, we have applications. Scientific applications take great benefit from elastic scalability of cloud environments that also provide the required degree of customization, allowing the deployment and execution of scientific experiments. So that means the major requirement of scientific applications is its elastic property and deployment, ease of deployment, which is supported by cloud. So that's a great benefit for scientific applications. And business and customer relationship management, especially the two categories of applications, that is CRM and ERP, both are available as software as a solution using cloud. So that is a great advantage. Then all these new opportunities have transformed the way in which we use these applications on a daily basis, but also introduced new challenges for developers that have to rethink their design to better benefit from elastic scalability, on-demand resource provisioning, and ubiquity. So that means when the developers design new applications, so they need to keep in mind the elastic scalability, then providing on-demand services and ubiquity. So these are key features of cloud technology that take it an attractive solution in several domains. Okay, that's all for today's class. So from next class onwards, we'll do the revision. So by this, we are ending the cloud computing syllabus. From next class onwards, we'll do the revision. And one of our students requested to repeat the Aneka Cloud once again. So in the next class, I'll discuss about Aneka Cloud platform. Thank you.